Okay, mulligan to six. And fairly awkward six-carder. We'll see if I can get anywhere with this. I feel like the deck is maybe punishing me a little bit for thinking I had anything good. Alright, well, we're going to run Sargatog out there, even though it'll be vulnerable this way. Oh, opponent was taking a moment to BM us. Null Mage Advocate, pretty legitimate card. I'm just going to run Arsonist out there. Sadly, I don't have anything to do with Sargatog yet. Okay, Springing Tiger. I'm definitely willing to trade my Arsonist for his Tiger. Obviously enough. So, in that thing goes. Okay. Yeah, I mean, I'm happy with that. I have Partic Lancer to follow up. Time to see what sort of action my opponent has for us. Nothing. Well, I'm just going to play a land and pass for now. Because I think I actually want to just Ember Shot that thing. Alright, now he's on 5 mana. I wonder if maybe he had Elephant Ambush and wanted to wait on using it. Zombie Assassin. Okay. Drew my vampire. That seems better. Yeah, I think I'm probably just playing my vampire here. Yeah, I guess I start by playing Mountain and attacking with Partic Lancer. If he wants to trade both of his guys for my Ember Shot and a card at random, I'll do that instead. Okay. So I think I'm willing to go ahead and do this. I'm going to Ember Shot the Assassin. And then I'll have a 50-50 shot of losing my Vampire, which is bad, but keep something good, right? And I think this Lancer is worth keeping around. Yeah, that worked out poorly. Yeah, that probably wasn't worth it, actually. Okay. So, this thing does work well against my my current creatures. That is surprising. All right, so a little bit awkward, but I guess I'll play this. Now I've got to figure out what I want to do with my attack. I could attack with the Lancer now, because at least now is a time that I can safely discard my land. So I guess I'll just do that. Trade my card for one of his, basically. Unless, of course, he doesn't want to use his ability. If he doesn't discard, then I won't. If he does, then I will. And I guess he's just thinking about it for a little bit before doing anything. Okay, so he's discarding. Ah, you're Splitting Rats. That's actually not a bad card. I feel like I got the better of that. Okay, Nantuko Calmer. And Morgue Theft, okay. And that, of course, got him back the Springing Tiger, which is the one that's huge when it's Threshold. That makes my job a little harder. Yeah, I'm kind of wishing I had just forgotten about attacking with Lancer. Said, to heck with Zombie Assassin and Null Mage Advocate. They don't really matter. And I should have just played the Vampire. Because at this point, I could be beating him down with a Vampire. Instead, I'm stuck staring at a wall of regenerators. So let's see what we can find. I am going to put the Ember Shot on the bottom. Oh, Reckless Charge. What do I do with that? I guess I can cast it on Aneurid Scavenger. And it gives me a way to attack with Scavenger and actually threaten to kill multiple things. So yeah, let's do that. Unfortunately, I don't really have a good way to beat the Thresholded Springleaf Tiger when it comes back out. I could find maybe a Nantuko Tracer that would help. Okay, so he is going to double block. That's fine. And he's letting them both die. Okay. Interesting. So he now has a 6-6 Springing Tiger, or a 3-3 Springing Tiger. And I'm not in any hurry to turn that into a 6-6. Ooh, Morgue Trace. I mean, Nantuko Tracer, getting rid of Morgue Theft. That seems pretty sweet. Yeah, I guess I'm okay with this draw. Yep, so there goes Morgue Theft. Then I will Reckless Charge the Tracer and get in there with all three of my guys. And he's just going to trade for the Lancer. Oh, he has an ability. Refresh. That's pretty annoying. If that was what he was... Oh, I guess he wanted to kill Lancer rather than killing Tracer. Yeah, that actually makes sense. I think that's probably worth 2 damage. Yeah. So now I'm probably not going to beat this guy. Acorn Harvest. Okay. Oh, it's only a 5-5. It's not a 6-6. It is still far too large for me to handle. Yeah, I kind of need Arcane Teachings. I could put Arcane Teachings on Sarkatog, and that would be a way that I could handle the 5-5. And I guess what I'm going to have to do instead is just double block. Hope that he doesn't have another trick. Because if he does, I'm in very bad shape. Alright. So I got that out of the way. Nantuko Disciple. Oh no. Now I'm in bad shape. Yeah, I don't think I live through this turn. In fact, I do not. Alright, well, this deck didn't work out so well. I wonder if that game would have gone differently if I just played Treacherous Vampire. I feel like maybe it might have. I mean, let's be honest, that was pretty bad. So yeah, Sarkatog has gotten big, but that doesn't matter at this point. I lose the game. Yeah, nothing I can do, I think. Okay, well, this has been Chris Davis with ChannelFireball.com doing an OTJ draft. Sorry for not better results, but I will see you next time, and thank you very much for watching.